Hi guys, this is Sushant Kochar, and today we are going to talk about what cardio is. And I am going to be talking about cardio in a language which might not give you any sort of scientific definition, but in a language with which a layman understands, and the language in which I prefer to understand, which can give you an idea about what cardio is. Okay. So, whenever we talk about the word cardio, we are referring to something related to heart, you can say. So, we are going to be talking about cardio, which in basically a word for a group of exercises which improves your heart health. So, that is how it is mostly used amongst gym goers or laymen. So I'll talk about it in that from that perspective. So cardio can be taken as a group of exercises that are good for your heart health, for your overall health. Okay, so cardio improves your cardiovascular strength. What does that mean? In layman's language, I would try to explain it in a way that it improves your stamina. Now, what stamina is? The ability to perform a particular physical activity for a longer duration of time. So if I can perform a particular physical activity, let's say moving my hand or maybe moving it faster for more time, I'll say that I have more stamina. If I can perform it for lesser time, I'll say I have lesser stamina. So it is relative. There's nothing like 1 kilogram of stamina or 2 kilograms of stamina. So basically, ability to perform something for longer duration. The most widely known and used examples of exercises which improve your cardiovascular health or your heart health would be running, swimming, cycling, walking or brisk walking, fast walking. So these examples, mostly the exercises that are included in under this umbrella of cardio word, I would say for a layman to understand that are those exercises which do not involve any sort of weight lifting. You are not lifting any weights. Even most of the time you are not lifting your body weight. For example, you are running. You might say that I am lifting my leg to run, but we are not counting that as lifting any sort of weight. You are not lifting a dumbbell or something like that. So your body is performing some movement, but you are most probably not lifting any weight. So the umbrella of cardio basically undertakes such sort of exercises most of the times, I would say. But that is enough for a layman to understand. Okay, now let's say we divide the movements in cardio in, let's say, 3 categories. Let's say there is a continuous movement. So I'm running with a slow or moderate speed. So I can run for long duration, maybe 1 hour or maybe more, maybe half an hour. Continuous movements for with high intensity cannot be done for too long, because our human bodies are not meant in that way. So if you try to run on your maximum speed, you might run for 30 seconds, 1 minute, maximum 2 minutes maybe. That is also cardio, but I'm not saying that it's not cardio, but we are talking about continuous movements from slow to moderate intensity, let's say. Now, the second category can be where you do a fast movement, let's say you run at your maximum speed, and then you slow down, walk, either you slow down or you stop completely. So you ran fast and then you stop for some time. A short period of time, 30 seconds, 1 minute, something like that, and then you again ran again fast. You started running again fast. So those sort of activities are also cardio, even when you're resting in between, because your body needs some rest to recover for your next upcoming movements. Now, the third category can be where you basically are lifting some weight, maybe. Now, you might say that I told you that cardio undertakes the exercise where you're not lifting weight. Okay, so we'll understand it better. Let's say you're doing push-ups and squats. Let's say you did 20 push-ups and then without resting you did 20 squats with your body weight. Now you took a rest for 30 seconds and then you again did 20 push-ups, 20 squats, and then you again took a rest of half a minute or maybe 1 minute and then you again did. Now, doing although you are doing movements with your weight, you're lifting your body weight. If not a dumbbell, you're lifting at least your body weight. But you're doing some movement continuously with either no break or very short break. So you'll be like, so when pushing your body weight in a push-up or your or a squat, you might be developing the chest muscle or your arm muscle or your leg muscle. That is development of the muscle, but the overall heart related activity happening in your body is cardio. Your heart, basically you're breathing faster, so your heart is pumping blood more number of times per minute. It is pumping oxygen more number of times per minute. So that thing happening is also cardio, even when you're doing something with weights, because you're doing that continuous movement with little to no breaks and you're doing it continuously. So that sort of activity happening in your body is cardio exercise, I would say. It makes this exercise a cardio exercise because it is working on your heart health. Now, you can combine push-ups and running. You might do some push-ups and then run for some time, take a short break, do push-ups, run for some time, take a short break, repeat. That is also an example of this type of cardio. Or maybe squats alone. So most of the times, if you do squats for long, for many number of repetitions, maybe 20, 25, 30, 50, then your leg muscles might not give up before your cardiovascular strength may give up, because it increases your oxygen consumption quite rapidly, and your heart has to pump blood very quickly. So maybe doing squats alone, just the squats exercise alone for longer duration continuously, gives you a feeling which comes to your body when you're doing cardio. So basically you're performing cardio when you're doing squats for a lot of repetitions continuously. Now, talking about some benefits of cardio, your heart rate goes up, which is a good thing. While exercising, your heart rate should go up. It is a good thing for your body. Then another benefit is that your body is moving. The best thing you can do for your body in terms of activity is move it. Your body is moving. Your body is a machine. If you do not use it, it will get rusted. So basically, you should move your body. You're moving your body. Moving your body improves your blood circulation across the body, across all the body parts, which gives better delivery of nutrients across your body parts, muscles. Improves your oxygen consumption. As you're breathing more number of times per minute, you're giving more oxygen to your body, which is again a good thing. You should give as much oxygen to your body as you can. Now, knowing that cardio is a good thing for our body does not mean that we should be doing it a lot or we should be overdoing it. Excess of everything is bad. Everything should be done in moderation. So, I suggest that you do cardio 15 minutes per day, or maybe alternate days,
maximum 30 minutes
per day or in one go.
I
definitely do not recommend doing cardio for hours. People keep running on treadmills for hours or using cycles or cross trainers for hours. I do not recommend. If you are a professional runner or if you like running too much, then you may want to run a lot. But if you're doing it for fitness, to burn fat, or maybe just for fitness purposes or cardiovascular health, you do not need to do that much. I do not recommend doing that much. Do it for 15-20 minutes every day if you want to do it every day, or alternate days, 3 to 4 or 5 times per week, maximum 30 minutes per day.
That is how I do it.
And that is how, I mean, I do not even do it 15-20 minutes, I do it 5 to 10 minutes. Either every day or maybe 3, 4 or 5 days per week.
So, I think that
pretty much explains what cardio is in a decent enough language to grab for a layman. If you like this video, please like it. If you have any comments, put them in the comment box. If you like the channel, please subscribe. If you want to receive notifications for my future videos, turn the notifications on. I will see you in the next video.